what we wanted to deliver, and the Russo brothers have done a tremendous job in delivering this, is a movie unlike any other Marvel movie. It is tonally very, very different. It's got the humor, it's got the action, but at the same time, we see characters exploring their situations in a much deeper, richer way than we've done in the other films. And there's a level of action in this film, and a level of practical action, of actual stunts, of actual car chases, that is above and beyond anything we've done in any of our films.
We wanted to come out of the gates full force, because we knew we were bringing a fresh version of Cap to people in this movie because of the fact he's evolved since audiences have seen him last. And we just wanted to throw people into it as hard and fast and as exciting as we could. So we went through months of just staging fights and shooting them and thinking about what excited us about them. And then from that, we sort of took our highlights, our favorites, and then we would figure out how we would take those beats and marry them into the locations as we began to find them, like the Lemurian Star.
Cap's mission when he takes over that ship is to covertly and as quickly as possible take out all the guards on the deck. How's he gonna do that? He's gonna move at super speed, he's gonna move with super strength, and he's gonna, you know, what we call knockout shots, right? Every guy, when he leaves that guy's gotta be out, because if that guy gets up and pulls an alarm, everything's over. So you'll notice that, you know, every guy he approaches is either thrown overboard or completely knocked out before he moves on to the next guy. What we're telling the audience is, in the 2 years since the Avengers, he's done all this training. So when you drop him on that boat, we're catching you up to speed on how he fights now, that it's real world, that it's in real world situations.
With that type of combat, to make it cool, I think you have the liberty to kind of get a little more of a gritty feel. This movie's all handheld. It's just a really interesting approach to a superhero movie. I don't think I've seen a superhero movie shot that way yet.
We want to move away from impressionistic action and into specificity, because Cap's abilities are all about the superhuman abilities. So unless you can, you know, you can really follow his fighting style, you're losing an element of what makes him exciting to watch the character.
We're down in Long Beach at the Sea Launch Commander, which is a very rare satellite launch vessel. And what we have here is a great sequence for Chris Evans, who's been doing a ton of fight training to really make the fights practical and visceral, fighting George St. Pierre. He's the UFC welterweight champion and has brought his own fighting style to the character of George Batroc.
It's an honor getting beat up by Captain America. That's all I can say. It's a lot of fun.
And in the choreography, we tried to put together a fight that played to George St. Pierre's strengths. Because his martial arts background and his MMA notoriety, we wanted to put some moves in there that people would recognize, and make him a sufficient foe for Cap.
It's a very action-heavy film, and it requires a lot of stunt work. And I think both Chris and Scarlett wanted to be able to do as much as possible when we got to these action sequences.
For me, just having done 3 films so far with Marvel, and also with this, you know, with the same stunt group, I know what the ins and outs are more. I feel way more comfortable fighting. I feel way more comfortable hanging 60 feet in the air.
Scarlett and I have worked together quite a bit now. Her double is Heidi Moneymaker, who I hired and put them together on Iron Man 2, and she's doubled her ever since. She is truly one of the best stunt women in the world.
Thank you to Heidi Moneymaker, who the two of us have now fused into one person. I think we try to push the envelope with each film, and there's already these kind of established moves that people recognize and are really into, so we get to play with that a little bit.
We sort of have a style, or we have her style, and so every time I come onto a new movie, I go with the flow, and then I start trying to put in really widowy, kind of flippy, twisty, lucha libre type fun moves so that she still has that flair to it.
A lot of the stunts in this film involved a lot of wire work, a lot of like pelling down things.
We had her up at about 3 stories inside of a ship with steel all around, and we dropped her down. You know, it was about a 30 or 40 foot drop, and she's shooting guns and very repeatable. It was safe, but she trusted us and she did a great job.
The Russo brothers infuse this storyline with a film history that they bring to the set that I think is very unique. They're holding this film up to some pretty high standards.
We used a strong visual element for this movie that we kept holding out in front of people, the bank robbery in Heat. Experientially, this is still the most intense 8 minutes of filmmaking I've seen in 20 years in a movie theater. How do we beat it?
there's a car chase written into the script. We love car chases, but it's like, how do we bring something fresh to the table in a car chase?
You read a script, you look at it, like, oh God, it's great. We get to do this gag, we get to do this gag. It's so much fun to be able to create these accidents and these effects and these explosions.
We're gonna pull this car in here at about 50 miles an hour, so it'll look like a very violent wreck. The way we're shooting it inside with Sam, you can really see, you know, that it is a violent wreck.
Give me the wheel!
I get to do a whole bunch of driving. I get shot at a lot. I love coming back into this world and putting my scar on and being Nick Fury.
Get me off the grid!
The story dictates the action. What's great about this movie is that it was constantly dictating some pretty awesome things.
The second act climax, the end of act two, is this huge blowout on the shoreway. We tend to write some of the big stuff in a white box. You know, we assume some way we'll be able to do something, and whether it's a CGI environment or whether we're gonna build something. In this case, I did not realize an actual American metropolis was going to say, yes, sure, shut down 3 miles of our freeway and go to town.
Marvel had worked with Cleveland before on Avengers, so when we asked to come back and ask them if we could have access to some of their biggest locations, they were great at accommodating us. And we feel incredibly lucky because if you see behind me, the pure production value you get from being on a location like this is something that we couldn't possibly build on a back lot.
What they came up with, I've certainly not seen in any Marvel movie, was really, really intricate and very different.
I think we developed a really efficient system between our stunt team, our camera department, in a way that we could execute these things where they were really well planned out before. There was a lot of stunt biz that was done. So the stunt team was shooting a lot of their fight choreography. They were shooting it from the angles we knew we could sell the hits from. And then they would bring that to set. We all note it. Everybody would give their 2 cents. They'd do some more notes. So by the time we got to set, we had a very complete stunt viz of the sequence, which made it much easier and quicker to shoot it.
We're actually coming down the middle. So as our heroes are running this way and this
way. So this is the car that is going to get blown up when she goes behind it. And this is the car that Cap has ricocheted off the windshield.
All of the fighting is last minute. It's really a fight to survive. Start!
It's all kind of a choreography, so it's sort of like a dance that you share with somebody. And there's so many little technicalities about spacing and kind of energy and speed, and sort of the whole thing like crescends into a whole different piece, and then it moves into a slower section.
Sebastian's a great Winter Soldier, really low-key, down-to-earth guy, showed up, you know, for the rehearsals and the fight training, was just a sponge. Just whatever you guys want to do, man, I really just want to do good. And I'm telling you, the guy is amazing.
My friends were making fun of me. I was just kind of like walking around the house for a while, just sort of flipping this plastic knife. I mean, I was like driving in intersections and just flipping in the car.
5, 6, 7. Oh, yes, that was nutty. Love it.
I think first and foremost, the credit really has to go to our stunt guys, Sam, Chris's stunt, James Young, who's mine. They're just really, really good.
We want this to be hard-hitting, so we tried to make it as exciting as possible.
Because Cap is such a strong character and has such a powerful moral center and conviction to him, it's like the way you test a character like that is just by trying to tear him down as hard as you can. We want to see that physically in this movie.
The thing that makes Cap the most interesting is when you take him to the 12th round, and he's beat up, and he's bloody, and he's stumbling, and does he stay on his feet? And that's when you feel the real victory in him.
Cap doesn't fly. He doesn't shoot lightning bolts. He punches and kicks. It's very meat and potatoes. And so with that type of combat, to make it cool, I think you have the liberty to kind of get a rougher feel.
We often like think of filmmaking as alchemy. What do you combine and how do those elements combine? And it's like, it's fun to take two elements that are a little incongruous and you're not quite sure what they're gonna do when you put them together. And I think that was the sort of two elements of the style, sort of like handheld verite, you know, versus like the massive scope of the world and sort of the big shots. We just said, oh, let's figure out a way to smash those two things together.